What do you say, 67% sustainable?
I'm going to say no. But who knows? It's 2021.
It's a fair point as Hintz's shot deflected and Ben slow to get up is...
That was an awkward collision. And Dave Zeiss out to check on him immediately. Little play in neutral ice as he came on Arvidsson. You could see the right leg buckle a little bit at the knee. And hopefully it's just a little overextension. And that didn't look good, though.
Again, this is the video we were watching from across the street at Madison Square Garden. The shot right there underneath the visor, or excuse me, underneath that chin strap and the mask of Semyon Varlamov. And you get hit there, you talked about it, the neck, the throat area. There's swelling to worry about as well. So even if he feels okay when he's leaving the ice, you worry about what he feels like 10, 15 minutes later.
Well, exactly. So, you know, obviously they're gonna check on him. And you never know exactly where he got hit. So there's a possible concussion there, Brendan. So maybe he'll go through some kind of protocol there just to be on the safe side. So
through Batherson has Tkachuk backhanded. He swept that just wide. Batherson after it. Collision there with Robertson. And up ahead is Simmons. Let's go back to Kyle.
Chris, this in from the Leafs, Nick Robertson done for the evening with what they're calling a knee issue, so the Leafs down to 11 forwards for the remainder of the night.
A collision with Greg Batherson.
Yeah, he was struggling going off, and that's why Marner jumped on quickly for him, but
being at the line on a good play by Bogosian. Now around to the near side where Thornton will cycle it for VC. Jimmy Vesey trying to check the checking of Cuckoo. Riley across. Bogosian, Leafs changing, and Koskinen's going to glove for a faceoff and allow an oil change as well.
I see Joe Thornton in some pain back on the Leaf bench. Let's have a look. Coming around, did he get hit? Or yeah, almost like he jammed his wrist as he got hit, when he's turning and making that play. So he was in quite some discomfort and still remains trying to shake this up. No, he's going down.
Go to the room.
It didn't look like an overly aggressive, but just the combination of turning his body in and getting hit at that same time has left him out of this game. So 10-4.
Nose to chest. Puck goes behind the Buffalo net. Flyers get to it. Sanheim to Provorov for a shot, and it hit Giroux's front and bounced to the corner. Al van Riemsdyk, right to center. Sanheim has it. Sanheim wheeling down low, avoids an hit from the cage. Giroux to van Riemsdyk. Just the line and steps into him and comes away with the puck.
Injuries are becoming what? Phil Myers left the game shortly after this hit from Jake McCabe, and then McCabe at it again just moments ago. Morgan Frost going for the puck there, and McCabe makes contact with Morgan Frost there. Nothing malicious about the play. It's unfortunate, though. Morgan Frost left the ice in a considerable amount of pain.
Saved by Grubauer, and Taves takes his shot in the head, and there's going to be a penalty on the St. Louis Blues. Taves slowly get up as he checks his jaw. Oh, boy. Taves, it went down immediately, Pete. Hit the post first, did the Blues, and then we saw what happened after that.
Well, here's, you know, St. Louis, a great play, but Taves, here's the penalty. He comes right into his head, Mosh. You know, that was a nasty, nasty hit.
He spent some time in the valley, did he not?
Oh, yes, he did. He skates. All the skates. Shane Doan runs a lot of skates in his off time, and he was a big part of them.
Holy smokes, Oliver Ekman Larson got drilled, and this is going to draw a crowd. Oliver Ekman Larson got hit, and he is down.
Well, that was Evander Kane, I believe.
Dave Zanobi off the bench in a hurry, and he's going to take a look at the captain. Now Lawson, Kraus, and Middleton having words, and now they're going to go. Interesting that Middleton for San Jose, his first fight was against the Coyotes' John Hayden. And so Kraus and Middleton are locked up, and a little bit of everything going on right now.
Well, I don't think it was Middleton who Kraus was trying to get at. It was,
no, yeah.
It was Evander Kane, I think, that laid the initial hit on Oliver. And he's leaking from the nose as well. Let's hope he's okay. Here's the hit. Oh, he goes in real awkward. He takes a high stick. Is where he got hurt as well.
It looks like it was Kane's stick rode up right. Oh yeah, yeah, not like the back, the neck.
A little reckless with the stick.
And across to Meyer. Ferraro with a shot. That's got through, saved by Talbot. Rebound is loose. Donato shoved it just wide. Donato to Meyer. Watched by Bonino. He goes up high to Ferraro. And back to Meyer. Winds and fires, and it was blocked. Bonino went down and took one off the skate. We get a whistle. 58 seconds left in the Sharks' power play.
Bonino getting some stick taps for laying down to block that one, and the Wild needed it. Sharks had the first half of that power play, or I should say the first half, the first minute of that power play. Sharks had possession, but really they had nothing. As it went on, the Wild started to break down. They got these net front chances. Wild had to battle here for this one. But overall, a good kill. Right now we're dealing with something. Cam Talbot maybe has an equipment issue after this battle in front. See if we can't see what happened.
So Talbot really moving gingerly in the Minnesota crease right now.
Yeah, boy, and that's not the equipment guy. That's head trainer John Worley. But that push off the post, looks like he went down and from there really didn't feel great. Able to get up a little bit, but wincing after that. Something about going into the butterfly. Boy, you hope it's not a groin.
And Cam Talbot flexing his knee by the bench, and it looks like we might have a goaltender switch for Minnesota. Remember, Talbot was shaken up late in the first period. He did finish the period and then came out to start the second, but now he will head down the tunnel, limping a bit, and Kakinen comes in to take his spot.
But I tell you what, I really like that move. Tough guy wants to be in there, wants to play, comes out for the second, tests it out, but puts his teammates first and says, hey, maybe I'm not going to be at my best right now. Might be better to have somebody else in there.
Denied a 5-on-3 power play where it looked like they could go up by three goals. Made the play. Now they're only down by one. So the decision to keep the Smith in after the first period has proved to be a huge one. And now they're going to get a power play.
Marcus Pettersson was hit up high right at center ice. There will be a penalty called here. And Chris Stewart is going to make his way out to tend to Marcus Pettersson's TJ Oshie, who will go to the box.
Certainly late, and it was blind, an unsuspecting player, and the officials can make this call on a defenseless player on a shot like that. Now it can be reviewed. We saw this after the situation that happened to the San Jose Sharks in a playoff game a couple of years ago, where the referee can look at a play like this and change the call, Mirzi.
They have the opportunity. In fact, all match major penalties are reviewed. That was a rule instituted last year, one of the rule changes. So they take a look at that, looking to see if the head was the main point of contact
at all in this call.
After review, it is a 2-minute minor interference, 77 Washington.
All right, so that's the option that the referees now have.
Oh, yep, he's checked. And Armia, oh man, there'll be another penalty here to Myers as he hit Armia, and that did not look good. Canadians react as you would expect. Armia's back on his feet, but both referees had a penalty signaled as Myers with a high hit on Armia right in front of the penalty box.
Tyler Myers is a big guy, and you can see the Montreal bench is giving it to him. Joel Armia heading right to the dressing room.
It did not look good in real time. And this, based on real time, you could be a major penalty.
Well, here it comes. Armia's got his head down.
Where's the principal point?
Well, I think it's a more chest. Here it comes.
No,
you're right. That angle.
Yeah, I think
both referees had their hands up very quickly.